I request Dr. Tej Kumar Karki to come up on stage and present his paper titled "Did Lee Corbusier Exercise Empathy While Planning Chandigarh City?"
Good afternoon. So today I'm presenting a topic on Lee Corbusier. We know he is a great man. He has done a lot of work. We have personal attachment. He is a great artist. He builds buildings like sculptures and all. So we have done a lot of research on architectural aspects, also some planning aspects. And we have praised a lot. But I'm looking from a different perspective now. So sometimes, you know, respecting the person, you have to question sometimes. You know, questioning, if you don't question, we will not learn. So all may look like a criticism, but take it as a learning lesson. The topic I'm covering is, did Lee Corbusier exercise empathy while planning Chandigarh City? This is my question. So we'll move from here. This problem is that if planners are less empathic, they are likely to fail socially. Less empathic means they are not paying serious attention to the needs of the people. And they might end up favoring rich people over poor. So you have to pay attention to the people's need very seriously. If you are not empathic, you'll do unjustful planning or you'll favor only rich. So what is empathy? Let's see. Empathy is considering others' emotions before making any decisions. Focusing on people's needs. That is empathy. In other words, you are paying serious attention to others' point of view and putting yourself in others' shoes. So what empathy does, so if you are an empathetic planner, you'll encourage information sharing, trust, there will be a trust building between people, and there will be a learning. The less empathic leaders are what? They are less receptive to others' concern. They suppress team idea generation. So less empathetic leaders also see only what they are looking for while staying blind to what is in front of them. They will not see the elephant in the room. So now research question. How empathic was Lee Corbusier while planning city Chandigarh with his planning teams, with politicians, with poor people, and with Chandigarh planning needs? How did I do this research? This research I did by book, journal articles, review of newspapers, and the one major book that inspired me to write is written by my colleague who is here in the auditorium. So he is Mr. Surinder, Bahga, and his brother. They have written a book, Lee Corbusier. Once I read that, I connected myself as a student of Chandigarh, and this inspired me. So what did we find in Chandigarh? So we found that Lee Corbusier was intolerant to the mistakes of his subordinates, junior architects, according to Jit Malhotra. Okay, the book says that there was a junior architect asking Lee Corbusier about his unclear handwritten notes, but Lee Corbusier showed anger, and also it said that he used harsh words. Okay, the next is, Lee Corbusier was confronting with the whole cabinet ministers in Punjab on one thing. He was proposing concrete, he loves concrete. But the entire cabinet ministers were against concrete, they were asking for wooden tables. But he was adamantly, taking a stand against all those cabinet ministers. He could afford to do because he had a good connection with Jawaharlal Nehru, and he came from France, he was a very famous man. But normally other planners, I doubt they could afford to fight with the entire cabinet of ministers in Punjab. Okay. So he did that, but the Pierre Jeanneret was his friend who was working with him. He somehow, you know, reconciled the conflict. He said that, okay, you know, we will see the concrete, if it doesn't work, I'll pay all my costs to that. So this is how he neutralized the conflict in the cabinet. Next. So Le Corbusier related the human organs and all things very well in his planning. He says capital complex is the head, a leisure valley is the lungs, a transportation networks are circulatory system. That is fine, that is okay. He has connected that, and he also talks about human proportions. But the thing is, the book writes that he had studied the mounds like mud huts in Punjab. He was fascinated by the mound huts, and he took the pictures. But I'm questioning that, did he pay attention who lives inside that hut, and what kind of problem he is going through? The other thing is that he was mentioning about the female workers, construction workers, with a lot of brick piles on their head, with children. But he was talking in terms of physical sense, in terms of artistic visualness. But did he pay real attention to that woman who was going through with all kind of bricks, with a child and kind of poverty? So did he thought to give them, I mean, how they would be a part of the city? So there were thousands of construction workers working there. And it is said that they didn't get any space for housing, and they were living in squatter settlements just outside. The next thing is that he also talked about symbol of open, to give and open, to receive. Open hand monument he designed. It's fascinating. I like it. But the question is, whose hand is this? Thousands of construction workers' hand has created Chandigarh city. But whose hand is this? Is this the hand of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, or Le Corbusier, or senior bureaucrats, or the entire low-income people who are construction workers who gave their blood, sweat, and their hand to create city? Are the poor people receiving, because 15,000 of them are living in squatter settlements? So it's easy to analyze human organs, open hand and all, but whose hand is this? The next is, less empathic leaders see only what they are looking for. It is said that in commercial street design in Madhya Marga, and he was so engrossed in that design that he forgot that is blocking the Shivalik mountain panoramic view. So the next is, he proposed a vast concrete pavement in sector 17 to make it very interesting plaza or open square and all. But while seriously paying attention to his love towards concrete, he forgot that it's a very hot and humid place. The entire concrete, if it is in the hot season, you know, people cannot just walk, and there will be a heat island effect on that. So in the pursuit of his concrete design, he forgot that the climatic context. Doshi was quoting his Le Corbusier site, that Le Corbusier used to say, one must be able to see everything, foresee everything, and then above all make allowances for the enforceable, unenforceable. But he couldn't see that, you know, ultimately the Punjab, Haryana, there will be an encroachment in periphery zones. He couldn't see and foresee that. So there is a Sahajabad, or Mohali, Panchkula, or periphery preserved area, they are supposed to be controlled area, are unplanned development. So I don't think he was able to see everything, foresee everything, and make allowances for unenforceable. The next is, he didn't foresee that the 0.5 million population will go to 1 million population. And what was his plan, that how you tackle when the population goes from 0.5 million to 1 million or 2 million? There is no mention in this plan. So he also forgot that institutional complexity. There are Punjab, Haryana, and UT. There are three agencies working there. So that's why Punjab and Haryana, they have illegally developed in the periphery zone. UT is there. So that's a confusion. When there are too many cooks, they will spoil the food. But when there are too many agencies, there will be a problem of coordination and conflict in the decision making. So I don't see you was able to foresee this kind of thing while designing or making planning decisions at that time. And at the end of his time, when he was very old, he said one very good thing. He has an eye to see and have the capacity to create sensation and have the instinct for proportion. I fully agree. He has created sensation and have the instinct proportion in his design. He is a fascinating man. But unfortunately, in the pursuit of creating sensation, he overlooked many human concerns. So the findings is, He focused largely on physical aspect, but ignored basic human needs and aspirations, inclusiveness. He ignored scenic value in Madhya Marga, climate reality in Sector 17, institutional complexity of 3 agencies working there, and politics of periphery development. He ignored it. So what is the lesson now? So what did we learn? So what we learn is, planners and architects mindful of empathy could produce inclusive cities. Empathy can help produce sensible architects and planners better planning outcomes. So I'm questioning that in 70 years after Corbusier, how empathetic we planners and architects are today in making decisions for the sake of people. We have to ask ourselves and be more empathetic. That will create social justice and inclusiveness. With this note, I conclude my presentation. Thank you very much.